Yeah, but this is the kind of guy who like thinks it's a joke to call people faggots. He thinks it's so funny. Ha ha, like he smirks at his own joke when he calls people that, right? But I think that beneath it there's like legitimate, you know, hatred in his heart for it.
He's proved as much.
You may be right about that, Rags. Maybe you're right about that. But check out, we're about to get a montage of his humor, right? He's going to show us how it's done.
Oh boy. We learned from the master.
No. Your son is a pussy. He will never be better than you, Kratos.
Oh, that's sad.
That was really funny, dude.
Anyway.
We're laughing at you, not because of you.
Sweeping Ham, so thanks to $2. How's Dad of War? More like Soy of War, or God of Soy, or Dad of Soy.
He actually did it, but like unironically.
And he was proud of himself, too.
Yeah.
They keep coming. Check out this one. This is another good
John
one.
John Winterman, inventor of winter.
Her name was Calliope.
What? Yep.
Calliope.
Yeah, she crashed to the
what
ground.
What happened?
It was long ago.
I killed her.
Funny.
Yeah, that's
you
what
know,
happened.
I'm gonna alpha your anus, Freya. You
at least I referenced
shit.
A man. What? A man in the earth band.
Then they'd have mouths.
Oh God! It made it worse.
Filthy, disgusting mouths.
What the fuck is his humor, dude? With your bow? I feel like I need to cleanse my palate by listening to N-word screaming compilations or something.
Sit the fuck down.
Cause you're a fucking little nerd and you're going for objective.
Sit the fuck down. Sit the fuck down.
Look at you, bro. You're 9 kills, bro. That is literally nerdtivities, bro. Get your fucking money up, you fucking black George Floyd welfare collection cotton picking torch market son of a bitch.
Hey, you got a
I'm not even remotely surprised.
That was fucking awful.
Are we gonna get the next
step? Wish I will find this man. I will.
This is pretty funny when I was 12. Oh wait, it wasn't funny then either.
He's having fun.
Oh my God, guys, I'm gonna get banned from the game. I hope Actman doesn't expose my YouTube channel for my racism. Why do these character models look so awkward? Look at him. Like, I don't know if he just kind of looks autistic to me, but like him staring off to the side and not directly
like
into
Mahler.
The camera.
Take that back.
Looks really weird.
No mask.
Does that
That's
not look
our
weird? Looks weird. I don't know if it's because of the upgrade or not. It just seems like the Blades of Chaos do less damage. I guess they're supposed to be AoE or something, but I don't like it.
No, we can fix this.
I told you that.
We just need to chase it off and scare it. Something.
There is no making things right. Only better than they were.
You heard it here, guys. You can never atone for your sins. God of War Ragnarok 2022.
Like some comfort.
That's not enough.
You like just can't engage with words.
So for anybody who doesn't know, this side quest is about how Mimir is trying to make up for all his mistakes in Svartalfheim. You undo all of the sort of, what are they called, right? Like the spewing, they're like mining things or something. Like little facilities.
Yeah.
You break them and it clears the water, the skies are clear, it's like it's getting better, woohoo. Then you find out there's this whale creature, and Mimir is upset because it's still here. He was hoping it had either died or escaped by now. And so you get all of the chains off it to free it, but it doesn't move, and Mimir kind of panics, and Kratos explains to him, like, look, sometimes there isn't fixing something like this, only making things better. Referring to, yeah, it's good that it's free, but you're not going to be able to undo what's been done to this thing. Its nature is forever changed by the fact that it was chained for so long. It's quite a reality to have happen
it's
in
just
a side
honest.
Mission.
Yeah.
Right at the beginning of the game, it's just like, damn. And Mimir feels fucking awful about it, but that's the reality. The damage is done.
Sometimes there's situations where it's like Kratos says, the best you can do is make things better, but making things right, it's just, that's not a possibility now.
Yeah,
and you have to accept that.
It informs a lot of the more regretful statements Mimir makes in his, like in the Norn sectional, which with Sigrun, like he really wished he was faster on the ball with rectifying his mistakes. Mm. Yeah, when he said, I think in the 2018 game, when he arrived in Midgard, his goal was to impress Odin, and he did so by being a man who is very capable with knowledge, but also impressing him by facilitating the deal with the dwarves that put them in a permanent, like, underclass. And then, of course, this whale he captured and gave to Odin. Harvested for its oil. Yeah.
Kratos is very annoyed at that.
It seldom is.
If you commit a crime, it is always bad. You're forever bad, says the leftist. Why the
You're full of shit. You're man.
Says the leftist.
The leftist
every
again.
Time.
How can't leftist. You grab enemies whenever you want? Because that would be too many mechanics for the average person to understand.
You said there were too many buttons on a controller.
I say the same thing.
Shut your mouth.
And there are grabbing mechanics in this game, so I don't know what he's talking about.
This has been asked before, but what is the optimal time amount a cutscene should be? In my Ratchet & Clank 2 review, I basically said 1 minute. I'd say like 1 to 2 minutes. It depends.
No, Ratchet and Clank has longer cutscenes than 1 to 2 minutes at times.
Wait, he's about to.
Okay.
If it's a major story cutscene, I say you could go up to 5 minutes. Like
there you go. So 1 to 2.
Oh, generous.
But if it's major, 5.
You could have a 5 minute cutscene if it's a really
entirely arbitrary.
List.
But okay.
Yes, no. Extremely arbitrary.
No.
Science.
He's got it. He did. Yeah, he found this out in his lab.
Story. Jesus, just watch the game.
So someone in his chat is annoyed with him because he starts the game up and just talks all over everything, and then they say to him, just watch the game, and so he gets triggered. But compare this set of statements with the ones he just gave.
Honest Whaley, you basically just proved all of our points. Watch the game. Watch.
Oh no,
the
watch
game.
The cutscenes at least.
Yeah, the cutscenes. You watch.
If you're gonna
cutscenes.
Talk about
just
the story,
sit,
which you
sit
end
on
up
that
doing.
Thought. Sit on that
this
statement
is their motivation.
For a while. If you do not see a problem with the statement, watch the video game.
Which you would do for any cutscene. You'd be watching the video game.
Yep. You are ruining the industry. Oh. You are part of the fucking problem. Like you could have a 5 minute cutscene if it's really important to the story. Scenes. You are ruining the industry. You are part of the fucking problem.
Yeah, I agree with Synthetic Man. Synthetic Man's part of the problem.
Yep.
Well, I think the soundtrack definitely not as good. There's no memorable tracks, so
no memorable tracks.
Wow.
Top comment, shitty soundtrack. Now guys, I figure it's nice to throw in a bit of a break for us. I'm gonna play the Odin. Sorry, the Thor song, right? Because I had to play one that he would have come across by now.
So far. No memorable tracks so far. The God of War is a coward, a weak coward. Don't you like your expectations being subverted?
Oh.
See what I mean, dude? This is the last Jedi of God of War. It is, and yet
because they did
it's...
something that you weren't expecting.
That simple.
Yes.
Yep.
Ah,
fucking awesome. Two God of Wars who don't seek war. Modern writing in a nutshell.
Oh yeah, modern writing.
LMAO.
So true.
Tears voice so bad. All the voice acting is normal in this. Nothing is epic.
I see why my sons fell to you. Even this lesser version of you. But I am not my sons. And your boy. All father has plans for him.
Nothing sounds like dramatic and over the top because Ryan Johnson.
I will give him. There isn't any
Ryan
lines
John-
like
Zeus,
Athena.
You
conspire
against
me.
Conspire against me.
My favorite one. Dude.
The guy who directed this.
Really entertaining.
Actually worked on the other God of War games, so I don't know why he's doing this subvert your expectation shit, but it's just the poison of California and modern politics and the way the world has shifted.
He's so fucking right. The poison. The poison of modern politics. Ugh.
I'm the only sane man in this mad world. The cuck writers want to kill Kratos, when Atreus dying would definitely be the better writing, like 1000%.
Okay.
What is that? What is that?
What was the point of that? That was fucking pointless. It was just like, oh man, remember him? I mean me. You know?
Dude, Rex into Ironwood, but sure.
Compare Odin designed to Zeus massive letdown. Yeah, no, they wanted to subvert your expectations. Don't you get it? It's part of the Rian Johnson experience. Does anyone, like, seriously, I want to know, like, any real human being, not an NPC, but does any real human being, like, oh man, I want Freya to be good guy. I liked her in the first game. She would.
Yes. I mean, yeah, I would like the stupid voice. Like, yeah, you can make any perspective seem silly.
Yeah,
but like Freya's a character and a really great one. Like the amount of work that they do with her.
She was on the same side as Kratos and Atreus for the vast majority of that game.
Yeah, up until the end, and then we get all the.
She helped you.
Yeah, but then we get all this pointless dialogue, and then she just joins us because of the poison. Yeah. Yeah.
But we all team up against the evil Odin. He's a fascist.
Oh no. Mind if I take I've heard change. About this. I
promise I'll be oh no, what is he gonna say about Ratatoska?
No,
here we
boy.
Fucking go. Pardon the intrusion? The old Kratos would have grabbed that thing and snapped its neck with
why?
One.
Why?
Well, let's be glad that he's grown as a person.
Yeah.
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 Let's be glad that he did not happen. Anymore.
No. John, the story is
Jesus Christ.
Odin bad, gotta kill Odin. There you go. Because we were looking for Tyr, but we found him in the first zone, so now I guess they're just finding a way to kill him. That's about it. Oh, I see. This is literally tutorial zone. What the hell's the point of that? You can practice your combos for YouTube videos and then make a clickbait thumbnail like, whoa, this combo sick. This combo crazy, bro.
I like how it couldn't be that the combo is actually really cool.
The name of those videos is Combo Mads.
I don't understand why he's shitting on it. And then he also said, like, what's the point of a tutorial area?
I don't know, man.
Yeah, you look at the definition of tutorial.
You can actually upgrade all your mods of your skills there if you want to.
Experiment with the game mechanics.
Oh. Could you?
Which might help you with your video.
That sounds pretty soy to me.
I'm pretty soy.
What is Tyr being a pussy? Because our expectations are subverted. Don't you get it? A god of war who doesn't want to fight. It's the classic cinematic soundtrack where there's no memorable tracks and the game is nearly silent when things aren't happening. Because God forbid someone hear a 3-minute loop of a good, memorable track in a video game, in a modern fucking video game.
Past the video.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're a nice little reprieve.
Nice sounds for once.
Soothing.
This guy did the Rings of Power soundtrack. Oh, nice.
Yeet.
Around.
No memorable tracks.
Damn it.
Go back in.
It's funny as well, because you can actually find on my stream, when I was listening to the tracks in the background of Alfheim, I started to remember. I was like, wait, this is a remix of what they did in the previous game for Alfheim. Like, I guess what I'm pointing out is, like, I literally remembered the track to the point of noticing how they've altered it. Like, it is memorable, at least for me, so I don't know what to do.
Nope. Naughty. Player choice, what's that? I don't know.
Wait, what?
He's annoyed he can't jump into the fucking River of Souls. Like,
okay.
Sorry.
So he can find one for himself?
Back it in, why not?
Modern game. Player choice doesn't exist.
A tempting treasure chest! Damn this sand!
Sometimes.
I wonder how much money they wasted having, like, a line of dialogue for every slightly notable thing in the game.
They probably know that if you get the sandstorm stopped, you can get to the chest.
Yeah.
The funny thing about
it is, I guess they fucking cared.
I would have criticized it for how you can clearly see the top of the chest. It's all clear. So you probably just punch through anyway.
Punch through it, yep.
And like, when is sand going to stop fucking Kratos? You can just blow it off. You go, fine.
I'm sorry. Flex how little I give a shit about this. Imagine if Atreus actually did become evil and Kratos had to kill his son. I think that would be more interesting.
Why do you want him to kill his son so badly?
He wants Atreus dead.
Violence. Violence at any cost, regardless of context. Kill him. Just violence.
Beat him up, kill him, reprobate him.
Atreus died, haha. Just asking for a friend.
Oh. This is like an alternate universe version of, Freya's house. I don't know how the hell does...
No. It's a big tree that she's hollowed out versus a big tortoise thing. Like, I don't...
Virtually the same. I mean, tortoises, trees, essentially, they're both...
Neither of them
They're both
organic.
Places.
They're both eukaryotes. That's cool. That's neat.
They usually like
Atreus not
brown.
Recognize it.
Yeah,
it obvious?
Slow. They're
I'm
both 14, slow.
The story is so deep. Yeah, really.
Why'd you refuse to fight me?
Every outcome would mean defeat.
What does that mean?
What?
I have never wished you harm, Freya. You helped us.
I'm disgusted with this Kratos. Disgusted.
Well,
yeah,
only considering how scars are made, it's no wonder
you. You helped me. I should have chopped your fucking head off.
Your fate was sealed from the start.
Faith can be overcome.
I used to think
no, so. Really, they're gonna shit on Spartans now. Spartans are absolute chads.
Sound like they sound pretty terrible.
It's so amazing. He knows nothing.
They would have chucked
Spartans.
This guy off the cliff.
Yeah, you
they
know he knows nothing about
don't,
Spartans.
Don't tell him.
I was gonna mention that earlier. In 300, Leonidas cries right before he dies.
We marched though we drowned. Fought for scraps or starved. Our elders beat us.
By the way, this is the speech he's like, wow, shitting on Spartans.
Still we could not stand. At night, we made our way home. Alone. Or were food for wolves. That is how Spartans are made.
They're gonna shit on Spartans now.
It is one
yeah,
rule of
Spartans
concealed.
Suck.
Because of this chip.
A fucking horrible upbringing. I'm sorry if you didn't
what
know that.
What a terrible life.
I still don't even remember who Freya is. I really don't. Like, it's not like I expect her to get over her son being killed. It's just this is a horrible, horrible idea. Like, this is some Marvel movie shit. You do not become friends with the man who killed your son.
She feels she killed Baldur. That's the point they make in the game.
For the choices that she made.
Yep.
You don't. And you also don't, like, Kratos, the guy who genocided a pantheon of gods is not going to be like, oh, this god is trying to kill me, but she's my friend. I can't hurt my friends.
Why can't he hurt his friends?
Remember, Freya saved Atreus' life.
He doesn't address it ever. He just says, nah, he'd kill her. He'd kill her.
Like, yeah, you have to ignore that to make that point. Like, it's the reason why he refuses to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Sure now. He grew up. Yeah. Fucking piece of shit. I swear to God, if one like 35-year-old man child with no kids and 100 Funko Pops is gonna try and tell me about maturity, eat a fucking dick, dude.
Very well stated.
Yeah.
Portals.
Okay.
Why couldn't they just do that at the start of the fight?
Because she was a bird.
If portals can chop people in half or decapitate them,
Nidok opened the portal.
And they just like close the realm tear at the start of the fight.
Take advantage of him trying to get away.
The game took care of this. They start, the thing is in the portal, and it's only once Kratos drags it and grabs it that the portal closes behind Nidok, and then she turns into Warrior Freya, so it's too late to use it at that point.
Yes. So,
but luckily for him, someone in his chat points this out.
Kind of an obvious plot hole, don't you think?
No.
You had a way around Odin's curse this whole time.
No. I discovered it once you unlocked realm travel, and it solves very little. This form is extremely limiting.
She was stuck as a bird, though. I don't know. Can't Kratos close the hole or something? Oh.
Look at her. Kratos close it.
No.
No, he can't. He doesn't know fucking how.
The super mega badass is she's like crying over like tearing a fucking forest heart thing.
Man, what? How can you? You don't know who she is. You just don't know who she is.
No, he doesn't know anything. He doesn't know what's happening. He has no idea.
My God, look at Kratos groveling in front of this strong female character.
Is he groveling right here? Is this what he's doing? What do you think groveling
means?
Joey,
I killed one more god than I should have. You say this as if like the Greek gods didn't have families. I mean, they were a family.
So you're making the point. What? Of the journey?
So he's like Kratos is showing some level of regret as to the actions related to Baldur, the effects it had on Freya. But why didn't he show this kind of regret for what he did in the Greek trilogy? It's like, you mean like his whole deal is the guilt and regret?
Well, and at
Greek
the end of God of War 3, right? At the end of one of those, the older games.
Well, like, a lot of people like to try and forget that God of War 3 sets him on this path. They're like, no.
Well, God of War 3 ends with him regretting the choices that he's made.
Yes, and then killing himself, releasing hope into the world.
We're related. And you killed all of them without mercy.
Do you know, I needed that clip, obviously, for earlier in the thing. And the YouTube thing put a cover up saying, this video covers suicide. Are you sure you want to watch it regarding God of War 3? It's interesting, it's like, well, I guess he does stab himself with a big old sword, but he doesn't die. I guess that's still enough, though, to be like, hey, warning. Graphic.
This can be powerful.
Yeah.
Even for the that's unworthy. My wife, Faye, taught me that.
Ugh, I hate every
day. Yeah, how dare her teach him anything.
Stop learning things from people who aren't yourself, Kratos.
If it was possible to hate every character, I think I'd hate every character. That this is just modern woke writing, is every character is unlikable as fuck.
Like,
it's
your own selfishness
hurt. It's wild.
Woke is when I don't like it. he's getting a bit more blatant.
You care about the most.
Everyone's crying and apologizing. How mature God of War is. They're expressing their feelings. Oh
yeah, it's probably a healthy thing to do. You grow up, you'll learn that.
It's a really sad moment because they're both fighting over, you know, who was at fault to split them apart, and then, you know, you get to this point in the conversation where they're both just like, I'm just fucking glad that you're back.
Oh, I've missed you so much.
Was this soap opera shit? Yeah, I know. No one gives a shit.
Drama's gay and boring and totally not based. Very cool.
Sword
dude.
Guy do anything? He has a sword.
Oh, he's got a big sword. He must be cool.
But he does do a cool thing with the sword.
Why does he just exist?
What the fucking nerve?
The fucking nerve.
Why does he just exist?
This guy just over here existing. He's not even in my fucking way. How dare him?
Is he like someone's self-insert? If this was God of War 1, 2, or 3, these mounting sections, like the beginning with the dogs, or when we were riding that huge yak with Angrabota, the black chick, or any of these boats, you would have been able to attack. They would have designed a section just for this. You could hit
Well, that's the funny thing, Rags, that you say that. In God of War 1, 2, and 3, and plenty of you here will know, when you go across like a long chain or you're climbing a wall, oftentimes suddenly there's just a horde of easy-to-kill enemies that appear, and you have to attack, and then move, attack, move, attack. And it's funny, I don't know if I said it on the stream, but like, I am not fond of those. They've always come across to me as we can't have the player moving from A to B without something happening. Otherwise, they might for a second think, wow, this is kind of boring. But the thing is, the gameplay on those sequences is so lame. Just like spam square until they go away and then you move on.
It's like it's also mostly the easiest enemies.
Yep.
You can either just grab and throw off a cliff or something. Just like, oh, you're just here to keep me busy for a second.
The player merely doing something doesn't mean they're engaged. And people need to stop thinking that it does.
Yeah.
Sometimes I just want to go somewhere.
Right? Because that makes sense. If your goal is to design a video game, then you try and make things feel unique, have the encounters stand out in some way. In a modern, shitty, cinematic Sony game, you're instead just, row your boat. Like, fucking, why? What? Fuck
you, where
you
want
dude.
To go, and then you get out of the boat
and
you fight all of the enemies.
Anyone who thinks this is shit taste and should never be listened to again.
Sorry, Mel.
What? I was actually
anyone
not
listening. Who says this is a masterpiece has shit taste and should never be listened to again.
That's okay.
That's
I don't
okay.
want you to listen to me.
I'm serious.
It's fucking 7 a.m. I'm so over it.
I know.
I'm so
He's
over
that far behind. I can't believe it. It's...
Because he wants him to make the decision himself.
Yeah.
I thought that was obvious by the fact that he was standing still.
That far behind after that long. He didn't immediately bolt after his son as soon as he transformed. Are you fucking kidding me? It's so poor. Great writing, guys. Great writing.
Told me.
Yeah, it is pretty great.
I intended to kill you in Asgard.
Heimdall? The Norns? I thought you didn't believe in that.
How could Kratos not believe in that if he literally killed the Fates in his realm?
That is why he doesn't believe in Fate. He killed them. What do you mean? He doesn't believe that Fate controls decisions because he fucking killed Fate. Like, he was like, hey, Fate, and stabbed it, and threw it back in time and trapped it. That didn't really make any sense. But the point is, no, he is not a fan. He got the information he wanted from the Norns.
That doesn't make any sense.
I didn't know it then, but I accidentally put his soul into my knife.
He put his soul into
the powerful,
knife.
So I thought maybe Fenrir's could
nature.
Yeah. Let's see if it took.
See, they subverted your expectations just to actually do it anyway. So now Garm is effectively Fenrir. Okay. I don't like them.
Why is he so unsatisfied?
Why
Isn't
is
that his
problem?
Problem
with that? Isn't this like a neat payoff that Fenrir's back and he's, you know,
Big
a good
dog.
Boy and he's Garm's got Garm's powers now, and isn't that like interesting? Isn't that worthy of some level of commentary?
Ryan Johnson.
I feel like under 10 layers of deeper meaning, the message here is trust your teenage kid when they make a life-changing decision, like chop their dick what? Off. A genuine.
Okay. All right. We're going there, I suppose.
From Atreus.
I thought he was
going to
say, like, adopt a dog, and I was so horribly wrong.
Shit.
Got that from Atreus trying something he wasn't sure would work and asking his father to help him and believe in him, and they worked together to do it. Got that from it. Just fucking poisoned.
Only there was, because he's done nothing. They built it up at the end of the last game as like, oh, this is the next big quest. Well, because they had to combine two games into one. You get Tyr in the first few hours, and then he does nothing of relevance. Ever. He's clearly fucking useless.
Is there any unfinished business in other realms you wanted to take care of? I'm sure the lad would love to help.
They're like, please go do our side quest, guys. We spent months on our generic shitty side quest. Please
do whatever you want. They're letting you know it exists.
Yeah, and you've clearly been complaining that there's not enough gameplay. And then you say, I want to do your shitty side quest. Then go fuck yourself. Then don't complain about not enough gameplay.
Exactly.
Fucking
what do you want?
He liked.
If I could, can I have more gameplay? Oh, I can. Well, fuck you. I'm not doing it.
You could have been doing that the whole time.
This song was almost decent for a bit.
It's from hell on.
You can't have memorable music in video games. It might distract from the awesome super special combat and maturity or something.
Halo laughs at you.
He's saying the reason they likely chose not to have memorable music is so it wouldn't get in the way of the combat and the story.
That's famously how good music works.
That's why everyone talks about the tracks they don't remember from the combat sections they enjoyed, and everyone talks about their least favorite boss fight tracks in the Souls games and stuff, you know?
What a bizarre thing to say.
That's what I'm talking about. Does this sound like two gods talking to each other?
One of them is high.
One of them is high, yeah.
How, in all the nine realms, did you manage to kill Heimdall?
I knew our spear would
Does
do
no
the
one
trick.
Believe that Kratos killed,
well,
like, a whole pantheon
Ragnar
of gods?
That Heimdall.
Heimdall.
Is the reason for that, if you check out these references.
I feel like constantly they act shocked when he killed another god.
The plan is to kill Heimdall first.
Oh, wow. Okay, Heimdall. Let's see. Never loses, sees everything coming, unpopular at parties. This won't be easy.
Kratos, I've never seen anyone so much as lay a finger on him. Not one.
They believe he can kill gods. They're not sure he can kill Heimdall.
Yep.
You're gonna lose her. You may be working with Allfather and enjoying his little.
It's a lot of balls.
Protection. But stay out of my family's business.
Kind of seems out of character.
Oh, there's two.
Just, I don't.
Wait.
What would you fucking.
The balls?
He's saying Atreus telling someone what he believes to be true in an environment that he's not exactly got holding all of the power is out of character. Atreus wouldn't be so ballsy as to tell someone what he thinks.
And he certainly later wouldn't mention to his father that when I'm not around you, I act impulsively and maybe don't make the smartest of decisions.
Yeah.
That would be crazy.
Definitely not in character, not at all. He didn't fucking stand up to Kratos several times in the 2018 game when he was, what, 9?
Mm-hmm. I don't understand what's the point. We already know Thor's gonna die.
No, we don't!
I guess he read the leaks, remember? So...
So why, like, I don't know. They're trying to get us to care about him.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, look, he's not...
What a foolish endeavor.
I'm going to give you a little bit of insight here. Everyone's going to die, so fuck it.
Yeah.
Just
a dickhead.
We're here. Mom and I are here for you.
Is this really the right time for this?
Yeah.
Yes.
Is this really the right... He made a mess of an entire building and he went on an alcohol-fueled violence binge.
He's just
and he
started
couldn't be drinking
again.
Anyway.
Yeah.
This is the perfect time for it.
When it would happen, his daughter has got a mission and he's drinking again. One thing he promised he...
Right time
exactly.
for this.
Look at his fucking face. He knows he's failed.
He's an alcoholic because his daddy doesn't love him. This is really what I wanted in. God of War! God of motherfucking war, dude.
Remember when he got really mad about that guy? Like, the fact that he made an argument that was in-universe, but he was like, oh, that's a meta argument. That's ridiculous. But every time he's like, oh, this is God of War. It should be like this. It's a meta argument. So, like, I presume he's actually pretty cool with meta arguments when they service his goals.
Imagine I said, you know, in the scenes where Kratos is dealing with either explaining or dealing with the death of his initial wife and daughter, and then I was just pausing and going, this is God of War! I want to tear people's heads off! What is this? Yes, that is God of War. Trauma.
The character.
Talking about how worthless Tyr is.
We don't need Odin
good.
To use this. We can slip into Asgard and do it ourselves, right under his nose. We gain the knowledge we need to shatter this prophecy of war once and for all.
Except begging your pardon, you don't have a way into Asgard.
Or, horn, what if oh, so using the mask and gazing into the tear is what causes Ragnarok? Are we not going to think of this as a possibility?
Please,
I feel like...
just.
I just thought of that immediately.
What is your reasoning for why staring into the crack is going to cause Ragnarok?
I don't know.
What's the connection there?
Yeah, it was never in any of the prophecies. It Yeah, as far as I know, the crack of knowledge wasn't ever mentioned in the prophecies.
I have no idea why he thinks that's a good call. There's nothing that connects it at all.
I mean, it's like potentially there's something there, maybe, about how the pursuit of... Pretty much, like, there's nothing to tear it to.
Us on the path to use the mass to look in the tear and start Ragnarok.
Maybe the tear would give him knowledge of something that would then say, like, if the story was different, maybe.
Will of the Force.
I don't, you know, are none of the characters gonna think of this? Whatever, who cares?
Indeed, who cares?
Now we kill Odin. And anyone who gets in our way.
Yeah, why is Freya more God of War than the actual God of War?
She personally really does... She's not very keen on Odin.
No, yeah. She doesn't like him.
She really doesn't like Odin. You would know this if you were paying attention to even modest amounts during your playthrough.
Vengeance.
Yes, Kratos, that is who you are. You are vengeance. That is your character. And that's not necessarily bad.
If it is so the personification of you as a person, yeah, that's probably pretty bad.
Pointless bad, scene. Yeah. I love how Brock dying was kind of pointless because Kratos managed to get the mask anyway from Odin. How is this?
His death didn't serve a character can't die tragically, and that's bad if it doesn't serve some plot purpose.
Even though
like
it absolutely does.
It totally did.
Yeah.
Odin is dead because he killed Brock.
Yeah, that's why Odin dies.
Yeah. And real, a boar is a black guy. What are you talking about? What?
Why?
Stop pointing at.
Keep saying he's a black guy, not just a guy.
What do you mean?
Like, Tyr didn't do anything of relevance, so it doesn't really matter that he was Odin. This is it, you know,
except poisoning all the abides, screwing with them, and edging Atreus towards Odin a lot, and
killing Brock.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah, like, I guess that matters.
I guess I should have guessed. He killed him just tier. Because they didn't do anything with him, but because the writing was so bad for a lot of the game, I didn't think they would do that. That's my bad, I guess.
No, you didn't read it in the leaks, so you couldn't pretend like you predicted it.
Yeah.
I don't know how the leaks didn't contain it, but they didn't.
Yes.
See ya, Loki. Take care.
Are you gonna comment
on
the Trace's flashlight?
Yeah, I don't know why they're doing this. I'm surprised he didn't just roll credits.
Huh. Well, I'm rolling credits before. Think of the payoffs you would miss if you rolled credits now.
He doesn't understand the payoffs anyway.
Yeah.
I'm not that surprised, but they should have just rolled credits.
I need you to hear it. I appreciate you so much.
I can't leave. I don't know why. Oh my god. I love you too, little. I appreciate you so much, Mimir. Everything we've had together for.
You too, Hildisvini.
Angry Boda didn't even fucking do anything.
So okay.
I don't understand.
Yeah, definitely. She didn't literally save all of the characters from death in Ragnarok, so that...
I wonder if there's some reason that wants to minimize her contribution.
It's so fucking strange.
Did she exist again? Oh, right, diversity points.
Oh,
right.
No.
Game's not woke. 10 out of 10.
When death arrived, he asked why the old man had called for him.
Oh god, this callbacks don't work if they happened like 1 hour ago.
A callback, it is finishing the story.
It's finishing the story.
The game's got plenty of callbacks, but this ain't one of them. This isn't like a callback.
No.
And why didn't she praise all of the ones that were from like 20 hours earlier?
He didn't know they were. He didn't recognize them. He wouldn't know what they are.
Just odd, because there were a lot of them.
Like the one thing he actually remembered.
10, 15, 20 hours. Some of them were in different games.
Yes, they were. Lots of them were.
I will not play it. I swear to you, I will skip it. I will review anything else.
That if they make another game where Atreus is a hero, he won't be playing it.
Mm-hmm.
I hope Atreus is a hero in the next
Scary
game.
Based.
Yeah.
Based. That's all you pill.
Good deal.
That's a promise. Remember in games when you could just hit something? I want Atreus to die.
Yeah.
Like, I want Atreus to die so Kratos has the will to, like, be the angry God of War again. Wouldn't that be so
that
based?
Be so
Kratos is a hero now. This one, Kratos used to fuck hot girls. Now he sucks. Yeah.
I mean, it's really a dichotomy. Fucking hot girls. Sucking.
Yeah, that's the two.
So I guess, where are all your hot girls that you're fucking, synthetic man?
Usually the one who drags
do they know that you live with your mommy?
Why do you care so much?
Jesus Christ, man. Stop asking the same question.
No.
Okay.
Maybe he's trying to help his son. I know that's crazy. Kratos.
Yeah, so he's listening to dialogue about Atreus poking at Kratos, trying to find out why he's so invested in saving the Hafguvaa. And he said, maybe just wants to fucking do something with you, which, if anyone knows, that is literally the payoff for this section.
Yep,
Kratos explains he just wants, well, Mimir says he just wants to hang out with you. And so what happens when he gets that as the payoff?
Kratos being a, I don't believe it either, but really, I don't. But, this is, like, completely pointless dialogue right now. Like, completely fucking pointless.
Father, thanks for bringing us out here, but you don't have to do this kind of stuff just to keep my mind off Ragnarok, you know?
This was not a distraction.
No? Then why are we really out here?
Have you ever considered? He just wants to spend time with you, lad. While he still can.
Really?
We do not know what lies ahead. But if Ragnarok approaches, I wish to enjoy the time we have left.
I don't know what to say. Thank you for bringing us out here. I'm glad we did this.
As am I.
You have nothing like to say about nothing. All that?
No, he has something.
I'm cringing.
Wow.
The cringe.
It's cringe.
You know, as we know, synthetic man, maybe one day as you get older and the people you love get older and things start to change in your life, you'll look back on the scene and really appreciate it.
Yeah.
Imagine. Imagine if they subverted our expectations in like an actually interesting way and Atreus just insulted her constantly. Would that not be awesome? I think that'd
no,
be
no, it would be
this
fucking...
God of...
I wonder why you think that's awesome.
War! I understand. It's the slaughtering the gods and screaming is more mature than this.
No, it really isn't.
Oh, yeah?
I will never let that go. Child. I will argue that I will die on that fucking hill.
This isn't who you want to be!
Shut the fuck up, Mimir! This is exactly who I want to be! Crush his face.
You don't care about anything beyond yourself.
Jesus.
Not the monster who kills without cause.
Like a Sigma male Chad! Even hope. So, you know, there's toxic masculinity's dead. Look, guys, it's a whale. Let's stab it in the eye. That's what Kratos, the real Kratos, would do.
Oh, no, you wouldn't just a child. You're an actual child.
Not even OG Kratos would just stab a creature in the eye for no reason at all. What do you mean?
Yeah.
Why can I not stab it?
Why would you want to? Why are you a dick? A time,
with nothing to occupy your mind.
Like, I hope
pain.
You don't have any pets.
He has a dog.
Why would God of War of any franchise try and teach you about morality? Why can I not stand it?
I don't know, man.
Because some of the people who play these games really need it, apparently.
Maybe.
You know, now that I know more about the Dark Elves, I wish we didn't have to fight them.
They attack us.
Well, this is their home. And considering what happened the last time we were in Alfheim, can you really blame them?
Oh boy, more God of War teach me morality. Basic. Yeah, Sony games are so mature, dude. What if
unlike
we're
you.
The baddies? Oh my god, crazy,
yeah,
dude.
I know,
who would have thought that? That's nuts.
Or they made you think. I don't know.
Like... Sorry, you're just allergic to the concept of introspection.
I suppose I should expect nothing less from half-breeds.
Don't call me a half-breed.
I will call you whatever I like. You have a lot to learn, little girl. Starting with who your family
is. Yep, Heimdall is the supreme gentleman. He's not. Like, if any bread tuber wanted to take me down, they could just pull up a bunch of stream clips. That's all it would take.
Well.
Wasn't well, interesting idea.
If you don't mind pausing it for just a moment, I'm gonna get a drink, and I actually don't want to miss any of it. So I'll just be a few moments.
Come on, man.
We are coming to the end, everyone.
Yeah, almost there.
So
almost
there.
I'm gonna see if he's gonna
it's
say
so
it.
So close.
So close to the end. What a. What a creator. You know?
Not real. It's unreal.
What a fucking...
it kind of does. It really does sort of... It's insane, isn't it?
What a garbage bag.
Absolutely. This is one of the worst humans we've ever covered. Holy shit. But don't worry, you fellas. We're gonna find we've still not seen the worst of it.
I'm holding on to my bingo card.
I know, you're all sitting there thinking, what do you mean? It's like, it'll make sense, don't you?
I don't even know what's coming. I don't even know what's going on anymore. I'm want to go bed.
It's been a while since we've done a near cap hour EFAP. Man.
Metals in the give me something for the pain and let me
die.
Yeah. Pretty much. It's fucking 7:30 a.m. I don't even know when I was last up for that long. I'm not going to sleep now, like that close to the end.
Someone said I'm just waiting for him to pull a Kanye. What a weird thing to say.
Oh, no. It's crazy
how much I knew it changed
in the last month.
I knew it.
Nonsense.
That's ridiculous. The train always ends at this stop. Every time.
The whole roads lead. Oh, Rags, hurry so that we can have something for the
Please.
Pain and let us die.
Hurry up, Rags. I'm so tired.
As am I. Are we all? It's the kind of thing you don't expect to do. I bet most people were here today that would tune into a normal EFAP. This has not been normal. And no, I didn't think I was expecting this at all. I was hoping to just find references to the game that I could support the review with, because I thought it was really interesting, a lot of the things he said. And I was like,
a bunch. Ow.
You could say a bunch, yeah. I hear a lot of names. A lot of careers getting mentioned. He's a very bitter man. He has trouble. The main thing he's after is attention. He wants more and more acclaim. He wants more credibility. Rags, you ready?
I am ready. I had to take a piss worthy of the memory store. All right.
Oh, boy. Here we go.
Okay.
You know, when I was a kid, it was full of slurs. And when you have slurs, then your banter actually has power. I fucking hate
Roman. If you need a slur for your banter to have power.
It's really weird banter. To phrase it that way. Slurs gave our insults power. Okay.
You know what? Banter, when I realize it, I try to keep those segments of the videos to a minimum. But it's impossible when modern games are so disgustingly poisoned by leftist ideology. Sure. Like, this input reading, I was gonna say a word, I stopped myself, thank God. This bundle of sticksery, I don't know.
Stop it!
Stop! It's You're like not even using it as a joke. You're just, like, actually kind of, like, being a real dick about it.
Get ready for this, Tate.
The hater. How could you still like her? I know Redditors are, like, soy boy cocksuckers. They're all secretly gay. It's like, here's the thing. Like, if you're an actual cuckold, I mean literally, not the meme version, but like, you know, you get off to men fucking your wife. You're self-inserting as the woman. You're gay. There you go. What? Boom. There's my theory. That's my dissonance.
That's an interesting theory, Freud.
I don't even understand.
Why not just fuck dudes then?
I don't understand.
That's a bit roundabout, isn't it?
If you can arrange cuckolding with your wife, but you're secretly gay, then, like, surely you could just fuck dudes, right?
There's objectively fewer people involved if you just meet up with one dude
we could
have
cut out the middle woman, you know?
Exactly. So to speak, yeah. And he should like that. Get rid of the woman. So bros could just be bros. Never. Bro.
Well, yeah, and if I roll it back, have him say it again. Look what he says in conclusion when he realizes how fucking stupid what he said Life. Is. Watch him struggle.
You're self-inserting as the woman. You're gay. There you go. Boom. There's my theory. That's my never mind. Who cares? Whatever. I'm correct.
What a bizarre
thing. Never mind. Who cares? Whatever.
He said, wait, Friggy. I'm sure you catch what he said at the end of that? He said, never mind. Who cares? Whatever. I'm correct.
are.
Oh, right, definitely. I'm sure it has nothing to do with like ownership or security or humiliation or open relationshipness or any of the different aspects that could go into that. It's because you want to be fucked by dudes.
He thinks gay people are lesser. He thinks bisexual people are lesser. That's the whole idea. It's like...
How incredibly based.
He referred to it as a flaw.
That's my obvious flaw.
Universal healthcare. You want to give these fat fucks... You want to pay more taxes. This is what the Euro fags... Oh, it's fucked.
Hey.
I said it. Euro... Pores. Euro pores.
Wait.
Don't understand.
Fags is synonymous with not having money?
Is
he saying pause or whores?
Pause. This is a 4chan thing. Oh, Euro right. Pause.
Nice.
You guys pay like over half your income to the government who fucking stabs you in the back and you have no rights.
Imagine tuning in for God of War. What the fuck?
Some way I do want to talk about how the women... I already mentioned like the female characters take charge and are... always
how
right or whatever. For those of you who are here, which is probably not most of you, if you watch the a whammon, I love beating women with my fists and my giant shield. Diversity, the strength of diversity. We have female enemies, which means incels can beat the shit out of women and get away with it.
All right.
At least I get to kill women. Oh, woke. I mean, I don't know. Freya stabbed Kratos and they're building her up to be a badass or something. That's about it, I guess. Just female enemies.
Pretty badass in the last game.
That's how it's woke. There are female enemies.
Scene was definitely written by a woman. Why'd they make Kratos such a huge
I thought it was Anthony Birch.
Well, no, it's on the writing team, there are women present, so we know why the game's badly written now.
Was
because
women
of Anthony Birch.
And Anthony Birch wrote this story.
There we
there
go.
Were four female writers on this, right? That's what people were saying. Someone told me there's four female writers on this game. I know Alana Pierce is one of them. Alana Pierce is one of the women. And we already know there's at least four diversity hires on this show.
Because they're women.
Literally,
all women are
diversity
hires.
They have to be diversity hires.
No
woman
couldn't have actual talent.
What are you doing, dude?
Embarrassing.
He's being a revolting
a woman
human being.
He's have just, real you know, talent.
He's being a revolting insult.
In terms of in the writing staff, Alana Pierce was bragging she got to write, but she's not credited as such.
We're not
she worked
letting
on the accessibility for dumb people.
Would that be the
really? Wait, so she
what?
Didn't actually write? Is that what you're saying? We were all... Maybe her writing was that bad. There were still four female writers, though.
It's like,
until
what?
All the... What are you doing?
Literally, that being female is bad for the writing. Absolutely insane.
Who did this to you?
And look,
you're the joke character that people think we are.
Yeah.
But you're real. You're an actual goblin.
He's got problems.
Right? Is that what you're saying? Maybe her writing was that bad. There were still four female writers, though. And look, he's on the ground. She's standing up. So already making him look inferior.
What?
Yeah, tripped over because he got spooked.
Oh my god.
There's definitely this is an agenda here. There's a fucking agenda here. Alana
what
Pierce.
What is the agenda?
Never mind. I'm not gonna say anything. I'm gonna get in trouble. I'm gonna get in trouble.
Where are your parents?
This is fucking. Fuck all. You know what? Any person who ever simped for her needs to be executed. And
what?
I can't say what I want to happen to Alana Pierce.
What the fuck?
Jesus Christ. What? Like, I don't like plenty of people, but, like, it's impossible to tell where the joke begins and ends with him.
We said, I can't say what I want to happen to her because I'd be bad. It's like, what the hell? You really hate
that's
a lot
of
peers, damn.
Yeah, that's kind of fucked up.
Jesus Christ. I do too, but I can say every simp should be killed. She's gonna peg
what?
Him. Maybe.
Okay.
Maybe that's the only way that... Fuck, I gotta be careful about what I say. I gotta be careful.
Oh.
Oh, man. A woman beat man at thing.
I think I got it.
Fuck off.
How dare.
Wait.
I mean, granted, he's never done it before, but still.
Hey! There we
you
go.
See, his brain was like, wait, you're retarded. And then he was like, shut up, brain.
Woman has to save a man. again. Oh boy, she wins. She won again.
Thank you.
She won again. She should peg him. So just peg Atreus. God, this is cringe. The cringe levels. Through the roof, dude. Hate all these badass women. Except, look, she can't even keep her emotions together.
No, she was a super badass right in the fight. Like, compare his commentary, and I liberally applied quotation marks, but compare his commentary with ours during that incredible scene.
Yeah.
Ugh. More female enemies, by the way, guys. A lot of badass women in the Norse dimension.
Dude, stop.
Yes, Norse dimension.
First of all, the Norse dimension. Secondly, lots of badass women in Norse. Yes, yes. There are one of them's called Freya. You may not have heard of her.
And the Valkyries.
Oh well.
Don't ask questions.
As many of our people as possible. My responsibility. One you didn't take seriously then, and from the looks of it, one you
woman
don't.
Good, man bad. You think this
is no way out. It's only
Jesus Kratos.
Not quite yet.
Whammon. It's a strong female character here to actually save the day, not the main character.
You have no.
And he doesn't pull any of that back when you, at the end, defeat Odin when with Kratos, Atreus, and Freya. But oh well. Well, he does. This is what I mean about the NPC shit. He sees stimuli and has set responses.
Yeah,
exactly.
Anymore.
Wow. So brave.
I mean, that's literally showing him that she got her wings back when he took him away from her.
Yep. Yeah.
Not woke at all, guys. Not woke at all. Oh no, look how strong she is. She's very strong. I'm weak.
She's Thor's daughter.
And the woman is very strong. You know, do we want to
talk about... She instantly says, oh crap, this is heavy as fuck.
Yes. Oh well.
Women. I suppress it because... I hate to say it, I never would have guessed me, of all people, would have female viewers. I mean, I do self-censor.
Well, they're probably laughing at you.
But, regardless, you know, we could talk about women and why I'm in the situation I'm in, but I feel like it's just a bad idea.
Wait, you're 27 years old and living at home because of women? It's women's fault?
I assume what he's saying is we could talk about women and why I'm in the situation I'm in, being I've got no women.
He's a bona fide incel.
Of course he's an incel, but...
Rex, I think it was more complicated than that.
I didn't expect him to just, like, usually plug it out, you know?
I
well, that's what incels want, death to simps, right? Divorced,
but, I mean, maybe. That's possible. I don't know. I figured he meant that he got crushed by a girl, and, like, now that's why he's living with his folks.
Oh,
it's all her fault. He's down into the Andrew Tate, rational male, red pill shit.
The grind set, they call it.
He's in the grind set, guys. That's why he identifies with a Heimdall. Because he could see the intentions of women when he looks into their eyes.
Bitter, angry, giving YouTube enough reason to ban me.
This is literally, this guy doesn't need to exist. It's just like they needed a black guy, because... They had a black girl, so they needed a black guy.
That's definitely how it works.
I don't even know what to say about that. Yeah.
I guess. There's literally no other reason for this guy to exist. If I was working for GameStop, it'd be like, fucking base, dude! I'll ring up that refund right away, even if I get fired. I wanted to say something. I wanted to say a slur, but I can't.
Oh, no!
What?
He just wants to say
slur. I wanted to say slur.
You know, if you don't, as long as you don't stream it, you could, like, say as many slurs as you want in your room. Like, no one's actually stopping you. You just don't stream it and you'll be fine. Just get it just before you start a stream, 10 minutes beforehand, get it all out of your system. Think about me and Fringy and Mahler and Jay and all the women in the world, and just get it out of your system so that when you sit down for your stream, all of those negative thoughts are gone.
It was racist.
Wait,
hang on. I get fired. I wouldn't say something. I would say a slur, but I can't say it. Imagine if Kratos was racist. You know,
no.
They would never dare. They would never dare.
I can't imagine why.
Make such a bold decision.
It's just because of cowardice. They're too cowardly to make Kratos a foul racist.
And that would be actual Kratos character can't be assassination.
He can just grunt.
The only racists are interesting.
I can't believe this is such a cloud. What do you mean?
Oh my god.
The racists, they're the interesting
Odin
ones.
A Trump on, allegory, man, you're so close. And he's upset Capital. That they didn't make Kratos outwardly racist.
Is depressing things. But so, the endpoint remains me and her, we obviously need to breed. And then I execute all my sons.
What?
And then
what?
Breed with the daughters,
I gotta
execute all those grandsons.
Wait. What?
You might not grasp exactly what he's saying straight away here, but this is one of the worst of all of the quotes. He is trying to solve the problem of Angraboda's skin color.
Wait, was it? Go back. What's he saying?
Oh my god.
Oh, I don't want to hear it again.
Breed. Breed. Can't be interesting. He can just grunt and say wise, depressing things. But so, me and her, we obviously need to breed. And then I execute all my sons. And then breed with the daughters. Execute all the grandsons. Breed
what
is happening?
What is going on?
So that he can have a harem of his own kids?
You understand? If he
is
does
he
that...
Is he trying to explain why Loki is the first Northman or something?
No, he's trying to say he can dilute out and make it so that the kids are progressively more white.
Because none of...
But is he
that's
trying to
somehow
that
worse
that
than
a,
what
that...
I was thinking. Wow.
Well, you got the incest along with it, so don't worry. That's a package deal.
Yeah, we got the murder, which is the worst part.
We're at
the harem of your own children... Which is also not great.
Not great.
And the purpose of it being to lighten things up a bit, shall we say.
Not great, no.
No. Does Dr. Pepper know you're
anyway,
wearing your merch?
Poor Dr. Pepper.
He would not approve. That's fucked up.
Yeah, a little bit.
The slurs have been taken away from you, so you use monkey emojis.
What the fuck?
Christ.
Yep.
This can't be real. What an epic based boy. What a
wow.
No based.
Stick it to those SJWs.
Showrunners are big mouth. They're really romantically interested in babies. Stop. Pull it with the anti-Semitic remarks. Better someone's going to use your feeling clips against you. Go ahead.
Come on.
I'll stand behind that one. The ones that I'm worried about are the you know, talking about them. Not right.
This Yeah, that fills out my bingo card.
Bingo.
Yeah, we did it.
Ladies and gentlemen.
I fucking knew it.
Here we go.
I'm a nobody, so as long as I don't do anything the algorithm triggers or, you know, do something nobody watches, then I can at least reference something that we all know what's going on. We all know what's happening. Opinions on Jordan Peterson. He's sold out and he's controlled opposition now. Just look at who he's hanging out with. I don't know what to call him. Like, Team Republican... something. I don't know. Small hats.
What are you
no
doing?
No way to say it without saying it.
What?
Is that
hey, man? No way to say it without saying it.
All what? Roads lead here.
Yeah.
Someone wants there to be an equivalent to the Illuminati, but it just doesn't. Like, that's just not how it works in reality. There are multiple groups of people trying to bring down Western civilization, and they're not all on the same team. There's a certain common factor between all the teams.
Stop
if you do
it.
Your research, obviously.
If you do your certain... research.
Never mind. Anyway, you guys all know. I'm preaching to the choir.
Of course.
What?
Yeah.
Course
yeah.
You are.
He's going full Kanye.
Common factor between all the teams. Three. If you do your research, obviously.
Yeah.
You know, certain... Never mind. Anyway, you guys all know I'm preaching to the choir.
Oh yeah, I'm preaching to the choir. I hope I never, ever can say that I'm preaching to the choir when I'm referencing my audience these things.
Yeah.
Look up some things I can't tell you to look up. Things about, I don't know, 2% of the population controlling a significant amount of the media and the government.
Oh,
Wikipedia
no.
is not a good source for a lot of reasons. Like, a lot of reasons. It used to just be, oh, anyone can edit the page. Well, it's not even that, actually. It's almost the opposite. Where many pages are constantly guarded by... well, they use bots, but they're still subhumans, regardless. or setting up bots to monitor pages.
There's no making this right, is there?
They started because of the noticing, they've started removing a particular thing from the early life section of many pages.
It is vengeance.
That's exactly the reason why I'm suspect of people like Critical Drinker. Again, I'm not saying he's controlled opposition, but there's just something, I don't know, I guess when you condense a problem to the message instead of naming them, which, yes, I realize you...
Oh, he's paid off in shekels by the Jews to not talk about this. Oh my goodness gracious.
I shouldn't be so happy we ended up here.
As you guys can imagine.
This is a revolting viewpoint.
I had no fucking clue.
This
what rabbit hole?
You. How the fuck did we get here? This was just a shitty God of War review, and then it turned into like a Freudian case study.
He's annoyed that Drinker won't name them.
Of course you are, dude.
You can't name them on YouTube either. But I'm just saying, BP Jordy, I've already said too much politically. Like, the dog whistles are not, like, as whistly as you'd think. The amount of times I've talked about a certain group of people that's already crossed the line. Like, there's no going back from that. It just shows how cowardly the right has become, that there hasn't already been an uprising. The founding fathers would have started
who are you
a boogaloo a long time ago. What the American government has done to us is far worse than the British government did to the colonies. So I'm okay.
Calm down.
How could you put?
And we all know who's to blame.
Oh my god.
He's made that perfectly clear, and you say you should have risen up by now. This is really bad. He's a fucking game reviewer. What the hell?
And I can't even rely on those cowardly Republicans to not say the truth. What's wrong with them?
The poll user.
Man. We're vastly outnumbered by normies.
Wars are won by those
good.
Willing to sacrifice everything.
If you're not willing to take up arms,
the cost of vengeance.
And I mean that literally.
So be it. No, don't say that.
What? No.
Some of the snowflakes will release a video exposing you. Will you watch it on stream? Only if it gets a lot of views, I guess. I'm not gonna give attention to a smaller YouTuber for no reason.
Everyone else is selling out, man. We need someone who speaks the truth.
Yeah. Dude. Also, I love Raid Shadow.
I realize
one of my
the
favorite
irony
games
of this when fucking G-Man lives doesn't want to acknowledge my existence. But I just think when it's like a tiny YouTuber who has no identity, it's a little different, you know? Like, if I made, like, this, what was he called? Something bread or something? You guys said his name earlier. Or potato, that's what it was. The potato guy. I don't think he is really a content creator, you know what I mean? I mean, maybe he is. It doesn't seem like it. But I don't know. Whatever. I can just be a hypocrite, I guess.
The classic disregarding of smaller creators.
And you just said, I can just
identity.
Be a hypocrite.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
You're just proud of that, are you?
Remember, this guy's all about integrity and honesty. He just said, I could just be a hypocrite. Whatever.
Super based. He doesn't give a fuck. That's cool.
Never be in a cult.
Cool to not care. Caring is lame.
I guess people don't want to address I exist because I have real opinions about video games. I don't think there's any game reviewers I trust anymore. I trust myself and my own opinion. That's about it.
And I genuinely more than I don't trust.
Tough man, keep being real. You're the rare exception in the ocean of mediocrity. Well, thanks. It does mean a lot. I try. Being the one real gamer.
You said that you're not going to change the way that you make your videos because they're not that important, or like YouTube videos, who cares? They're not relevant for long.
Oh, he's keeping it real.
Oh, right, yeah, of course.
It's not good, guys. It's not good.
Why can't we just
everyone's against
these guys
me.
To the mat?
I don't even know if anyone has any real opinions anymore. It's just everyone is a
fucking
except
for you,
liar,
right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Everyone's a fucking liar. He's the
everyone's
one.
A liar.
Spoilers, the video is going to be called God of War Ragnarok is the New Last Jedi because it exists.
Oh.
What happened?
Oh man.
Well, not really.
Weird.
Just to subvert your expectations. But again, all these people, these supposed people with integrity that you can always trust if a game is good, don't fucking tell you this.
You didn't tell them it.
Yeah.
Okay, you changed your title because you're a coward. You knew that God of War Ragnarok is not a masterpiece, it's an approvable fucking title. Knew it. You couldn't put it to the thing you said you'd do, and then said all this shit about integrity. So interesting.
See, this guy doesn't have very strong principles, or is a liar, as are many people on YouTube. The only people I start shit with are people I know.
And there's one more clip that really isn't going to be a surprise to any of you. At least it's not spicy.
You're being invited on the Sitch and Adam show. Beats me, dude. I've never been invited to anything.